Where we are in the Afghan war right now, and when I talk about Afghanistan, I also always talk about Pakistan, because it's not just about one country. And as is the case actually globally, it seems there are always significant regional issues, whether it's focused on a specific country or not, that we've got to pay attention to. So it's Afghanistan and Pakistan, and on that border between the two countries. Oftentimes not recognized as a border, by the way, in terms of the tribes who live there. That is the epicenter of terrorism in the world. And there are, the main goal with respect to what we're doing in that part of the world is make sure Al-Qaeda cannot repeat what they did before, and essentially to get them to a point where they're incapable of doing that. And actually they've had some pretty significant, they've been impacted very significantly over the course of the last couple of years. But it's not just Al-Qaeda. There are multiple terrorist organizations who live on that border and who now, while not previously liking each other a lot, they work together in a much more synergistic way than they used to. And many of those organizations, led by Al-Qaeda, wake up every morning looking to kill as many Americans as they possibly could and other Westerners. A friend of mine said at 911, if Al-Qaeda could have, they killed 3,000 Americans, if they could have killed 30,000 or 300,000, they would have. They still seek to do that, even though they have been impacted. And so making sure that doesn't happen is what the president is very, very focused on. With respect to Afghanistan, and we've certainly had a history of ups and downs there, both recent and historically. The first question I still get when I go out there is, are you going to leave us this time? Because we left them in 1989, both countries. We sanctioned Pakistan, and we're still digging ourselves out of a 12-year hole that we dug when we sanctioned them before. And Pakistan's a country who's economically in trouble, who's from a development standpoint is clearly struggling right now and has a significant internal terrorism problem that they're trying to deal with. So the overall strategy is to engage in the region, and in Afghanistan there are 49 countries with military forces in Afghanistan. So this isn't like it's the United States alone. This is a commitment of NATO, 28 countries, and another 21 countries beyond that, which is pretty significant, and I think sends a strong message about the level of concern. That said, we're on a path to start to draw down our troops this summer in July in Afghanistan. We've made a lot of progress over the course of the last year of training and developing the Afghan security forces. They will take the lead throughout their country no later than 2014. Under the current policy, and my expectation is we'll meet that. So from a security standpoint, I think we're actually turning the tide, if you will. Taliban had a very, very bad year in 2010, and they're going to have another bad one this year. This is going to be a tough year because we are also going to lose a lot of people, which we did last year as well, and I want to be very straightforward about that. This isn't done without considerable sacrifice. So from the security standpoint, I actually think we're headed in the right direction. We've got to move, I think, more swiftly in the governance piece so that the Afghan people have respect for those who are governing them. We see in places like Marja, in Helmand, if you go to the bazaar right now in Helmand, it's a place that people, or in Marja, it's a place you couldn't imagine a year ago February, because we've dug the Taliban out of their own safe havens. We see local civilian leaders, starting to step forward and provide for their people. And then specifically on the border, there are two big, tough fights. One is down south in Kandahar, and the other is in what we call the eastern sector on that border. We've made a lot of changes, and actually we've made a lot of progress there. So from a security standpoint, I see us heading in the right direction, and I think we'll be in a better place at the end of this year, after this fighting season, which is just starting, although we certainly fought throughout the winter as well. So in the November timeframe, I think we'll have a very clear view, not just on where we are, but on the right way ahead. But by and large, I think we've got the strategy right, the resources right, the leadership right, and the commitment, not just from the United States, but from the international community.